Good afternoon, everyone.
很高兴参加今天的会议，与大家一起交流和探讨上海中心大厦的消防安全设计。
So today I'm very glad to be here to have the exchanges with all of you regarding the firefighting system in Shanghai Tower.
上海中心大厦是目前为止中国最高的超高层建筑。
So Shanghai Tower, until now, is the tallest and super tall building in China.
超高层建筑是人类智慧进行的反应，也是现代技术的象征，也是城市社会发展的一个重要标志。
The super tall building is the crystallization of the wisdom of human being, and it is also the reflection of modern science and technology, as well as the important icon of the urban development.
根据有关部门的统计，截止2011年6月份，上海市共有超高层建筑499栋，其中160栋是商业用的超高层建筑。
And until June 2011 in Shanghai, there are 499 tall buildings, among which 160 of them are for the commercial use.
随着经济社会的发展和城市的发展，超高层建筑将越来越多。
Due to economic and urban development, we are going to see an increasing number of super tall buildings in the future.
但是超高层建筑的消防安全是全世界面临的共同难题和挑战。
However, the fire protection in super tall buildings has already become a shared challenge across the world.
这几幅照片记录了在超高层建筑当中发生的一些大火。
And these pictures have already showed some fire disasters in super tall buildings.
这些超高层建筑火灾也反映出超高层建筑一旦发生火灾扑救是极为困难的。
Judging from these pictures, we can also imagine that it is extremely difficult for us to put out these fires in case of any occurrence at these super tall buildings.
所以我们必须对超高层建筑的消防安全予以高度的重视。
So we have to attach a great importance to the fire protection at high buildings.
上海中心是超高层建筑，它的消防安全设计也引起了社会的高度关注。
So because the Shanghai Tower is also a super tall building, so that's why the Shanghai Tower design of firefighting system is already become a big concern to the society.
上海中心有以下几个主要特点，一是重要的地理位置。
So, yeah, let's take a look at some characteristics of Shanghai Tower. First of all, it is located in a very important geography.
二是超大的建筑规模。
And also, it is of a huge scale.
三是多样的使用功能。
And it is of multiple functions.
四是独特的建筑造型。
And also, it is of very unique.Structure.
五是新颖的建筑结构体系。
And it is also a brand new structural system.
六是复杂的机电系统。
And it also has a very complicated electromechanical system.
关于机电系统的复杂性，刚才刘总已经做了是详细的介绍。
So I think our previous keynote speaker has already elaborated how complicated the electromechanical system is.
这些特点也决定了上海中心在消防设计当中面临着一些难题和挑战。
Because of all those features, we can imagine it is quite challenging for Shanghai Tower in terms of fire safety.
首先是建筑结构的消防安全。
First is the structural safety.
因为建筑结构，我想大家都比较了解，这里不多说。但是它钢结构的升降行架、防带行架以及中厅的钢结构支撑体系，它的安全直接关系到整个大楼的消防安全。
So I believe that you are all familiar with the structure. For instance, the steel outrigger truss, the steel belt truss, and the steel curtain walls supporting systems, they are of key importance to the fire safety of the entire tower. Next is the atrium fire safety. And you can see this is a double facade system, the internal one and also the external one. And you can see different distances between the internal and external facades. And the shortest distance is around 1 meter, and the longest distance spans more than 10 meters. So you can see it is composed of many types of atrium.
中厅的防火分割以及机构的保护, 中厅的防喷烟系统, 中厅的火灾报警和自动灭火系统的设计, 也直接关系到整个建筑的消防安全。
And because of the different sizes and shapes and the design of the firefighting system and also the fire detection, the smoke control and the fire alarming systems are of key importance to the safety for the entire tower.
三是人员的安全疏散问题。
And next is the challenge in terms of the evacuation safety.
疏散时间与建筑的高度、人员的密度是成正比的。
Well, the evacuation time is directly proportional to the building height and the occupant density of the building.
建筑越高，人员越多，疏散时间就越长。
Well, the higher the building, the more people inside the building, then the longer time is required for evacuation.
上海中心大厦是632米的超高层建筑，容纳人所3万之多，其人员的安全疏散是一个非常棘手的问题。
The Shanghai Tower is as tall as 632 meters, and it can accommodate more than 30,000 people. So that's why it is a hugely challenging for us to evacuate all the occupants.
第四是消防的供水问题。
Then is the challenge in terms of the water supply.
如何把消防灭火用水供到300多米的高度？ 如何保持高层部位消防供水的稳定性，这些关系到整个大楼消防安全水准。And
how can we deliver and transfer the fire water up to the floor, for example, more than 300 meters? And how to keep the fire water supply in a very reliable condition? So this is of key importance to the fire safety of the whole tower.
总体上来说，针对上述难题，上海中心大厦的消防安全设计主要依据国家和地方的消防规范，同时也采纳了应用了性能化设计。
And for the fire safety, and Shanghai Tower has already applied the local and the national codes. And besides, we have also adopted the performance-based fire design.
因为是传统的处方上的规范，他所提出的一些消防安全措施，对于如此复杂的多用途的超高层建筑是不能完全涵盖的。
Well, because the prescriptive measures required by the code may not be effective, may be ineffective or inefficient for such a complicated building or complicated occupancy.
当规范 不明确或严格执行国家规范和地方规范，会影响建筑的使用功能和建筑造型的时候，可以应用性能化设计来解决一些疑难问题。
It is considered that the performance-based fire safety design should be applied to solve unusual and unique problems in complex high-rise buildings where fire requirements are not fully addressed by Chinese national codes or where strict compliance with codes compromises the function of the building.
新的话设计它有许多优点。
And so, there are a lot of advantages of performance-based fire safety design.
它所确定的总体目标和性能目标是可接受的。
Yeah, it can set up a very acceptable goals and functional objectives.
它是根据建筑的特殊性进行有针对性的设计。
And this is a customized design according to circumstances of special buildings.
它强调主动消防和被动消防的有机结合是综合性的考虑。
So it emphasizes a comprehensive fire protection strategy based on both active and passive strategies.
它是设计更加自由和灵活。
It can come up with more flexible and freer design.
是设计更加科学合理。
It makes the design more scientific and reasonable.
上海中心性能化消防设计的范围主要有以下几点。
So the scope of performance-based approach in Shanghai Tower can be classified as below.
这是中心防火分割方式以及机构的保护。
Yeah, one is the method of fire protection isolation of basement and the structural protection.
二是中庭的火灾报警系统和灭火系统的设计分析。
And then is the design of fire detection and alarm system and fire extinguishing system for atrium.
三是中庭防烟排烟系统设计的合理性分析。
And then is the reasonable design of smoke control system.
第四是大楼整体疏散以及 穿梭电梯辅助疏散合理性可行性的分析。
And also the analysis of all occupants' evacuation and high-speed shuttle elevators for the use of emergency evacuation.
阿建公司应用 FDS 软件设计了两个火灾场景来分析中庭在发生火灾情况下的环境温度。
So by applying the FDS and actually two scenarios have been designed in order to analyze the environmental or ambient temperature of the atrium during the fire.
火灾产品A是位于内外五墙之间的间距为2米处的办公区。
And fire A is in the office here. Area of the atrium where the distance between the curtain walls is 2 meters.
火灾场景B位于内外五墙间距为4米处的办公区。
While fire B is on the floor where the space and distance is 4 meters between the curtain walls.
模拟记录显示内外五墙之间间距为2米处烟囱效应是比较明显的。
We can see that according to FDS modeling, it shows that the stack or the smoking effect will be reduced wherever the space between curtains is 2 meters.
4米处的烟囱效应呢，是相对来说是减弱了。
So actually at 2 meters, and we will see very high effect. With 4 meters, the effect will be reduced.
这张表呢是显示了火灾场景A和B 的环境火灾温度，这里呢是高度，分别是距休闲层，也就是中庭大堂楼板5米处，4米处55米处，火灾 A是500度，4米处230度，55米处是240度，火灾场景 B 同样的5米处是500度，但是在4米处温度相差。 这是200度，一个是180度。
And you can see the comparison of the FDS modeling, and the height refers to the height away from the atrium lobby, and you can see the height ranges from 5, 10, and 55. For fire B, here the temperature is measured at 500, 230, and 240 respectively. However, for fire B, so for 5 meters height, it's the same, also 500. However, at 10 meters height, fire B, the temperature is 200, and at 55, the temperature is 180.
根据新的话风险，要求对2至8区中心底部 三层的钢筋滑梁吊杆及对应后的方面的钢筋构水平支撑，以及顶层的滑梁采用防火保护措施，构建的耐火期限要求不低于1.5小时，其中身边行架和环带行架采用后勤的防火喷涂，耐火期限不低于3小时。
According to FDS results, steel structure components such as the bell beams, trusses, radiant supports located within the range of 3 floors at the bottom and the top, bell trusses of the atrium protected by the fireproof coating, the steel structures and fire resistance rating cannot be below 1.5 hours. The biggest truss and bell truss design should be at least 3 hours fire rating.
根据性能化设计风险，这个上海中心内幕墙采用了两种形式。
And according to the performance-based fire design, and we can see the double facade has been introduced.
就是 B1 和 B8， 这里呢就是 B1 系统，它的安装是在从第三层开始到顶部，也就是在发生火灾的情况下，环境温度不超过240度的部位。
And two types of curtain walls used for the interior wall, namely B1 and B8. B1 curtain was designed from the third level to the top of the atrium, where the environmental temperature should not be reached 240 degrees centigrade in case of fire.
而 B8 的幕墙是安装在底下三层部位。
And you can see that the B8 is installed at the bottom three layers.
B1 和 B8 的幕墙主要区别在于 B1 是铝框的，加胶钢化玻璃加中工加单片防火玻璃。
And the difference between the B1 and the B8 materials are as follows. For the B1, it uses the laminated tempered glass plus fire-resistant glass plus aluminum framework.
而 B8 它是耐火钢框加单片防火玻璃加中工再加单片防火玻璃。
For the B8, you can see that it uses the insulated fire-resistant glass plus the fire-resistant steel framework.
这是 B1 内幕墙，它因为采用的是铝框的，所以呢采用窗色喷淋系统进行保护。
So you can see B1 curtain, the aluminum curtain wall with the laminated tempered glass and the fire resistant glass was designed to be protected by window sprinkler system.
B8 系统因为采用了耐火钢，又采用的是双片防火玻璃，所以它没有采用窗喷保护。
Because for B8, it is made of a steel structure and a fire-resistant steel structure, so the window sprinkling system is not used for B8.
对中心的火灾探测和报警系统，根据应急风险，在每个中心分三层设置空气采样火灾报警系统，分三层：下部、中部和上部。
And each atrium is arranged in 3 layers of air sampling detection system. The bottom one, the middle one, and the upper one.
这个是小的是白点，就是火灾气气是探测器的这个气气。
So you can see the white dots, actually they are these fire detection and alarm systems.
对于中厅的自动灭火系统，采用的是在距中厅楼板10米高度处的灯带设置自动跟踪扫描的洒水灭火系统。
And for the fire suppression system for the atrium, the automated tracking and scanning water fire fighting system has been designed at 10 meters height above the lobby floor.
主要因为是如果采用普通的喷淋系统，它没有这个是合适的安装部位。如果安装在这个灯带上，普通的喷淋系统不能全覆盖整个中庭，所以呢是采用了是大空间自动洒水系统，在这个是灯带上进行是全覆盖。
The reasons why we cannot install the general sprinkling system is that we cannot find the right locations. Yeah, if we are going to install the sprinklers on all those lighting belts, it means that not every area can be covered. So that's why we have installed this automatic tracking and scanning system.
关于中厅的排烟，根据新文化风情，采取了这是上海下送的模式。
So actually, we have made the smoke control system designed for the nation, and we have also adopted the makeup air supply at the bottom in each nation.
也就是说是在每层中厅的上部，也就是在那个是上面是设备层设置了这个是大功率的排烟风机，排烟量是22万立方米。
So you can see that the capacity of smoke extraction in the atrium that is on the top of the ceiling is recommended to be 220,000 cubic meters per hour.
这是在设备层外的，这个是室外外廊，它是通过这个是排烟机直接排到是室外，每个这个是每个区呢都是这样的形式。
So you can see that the exhaust that can be discharged to the outside.
对于这个是送风系统，也是设一万，它是从这个是在这个是设备层下部进行这个是吸收新鲜空气，然后通过风管在大堂内部响处这一圈都是送风口，进行是送风。
So you can see that the fresh air delivery is also as large as 110,000 cubic meters per hour. You can see that the fresh air can be delivered here from the bottom and then via the wind pipeline, and then the fresh air can be delivered to the lobbies.
对于疏散楼梯的设计，主要是根据了国家的规范进行设计的。
And we have applied the national regulations and codes for the evacuation system.
根据国家的规范，在整个大楼里边设计了8个避难层。
And 8 refugee floors have been designed in the building.
在每个中厅都有一个楼梯，直接通向避难层。
And there's also one additional egress staircase for each atrium in order to lead you to the evacuation or the refugee floor.
根据新文化的这个模拟，如果通过大的楼梯疏散整个楼内的人员，所需的时间是138分钟。
According to the simulation and analysis by the performance-based fire design, the conclusion shows that it will take around 138 minutes to evacuate the entire occupants from the buildings by stairs.
经过新文化的风险，那么是提出，除了是三台消防电梯之外，利用13台高速仓储电梯，用于紧急情况下的人员安全疏散。
And in addition to the 3 firefighting elevators, and also based on the performance-based fire design, another 13 high-speed shuttle elevators are also designed for the emergency evacuation.
对于用于紧急疏散的仓储电梯，在设计上采取了防火、防水、防烟的这个设计，同时采用了消防供电，保证它运行的安全。
And all those elevators have been designed with fire protection measures, fireproof, waterproof, smoke-proof shafts, and dependable power supply.
这样疏散时间就从138分钟缩短为108分钟。
So as a result, the evacuation time can be reduced from 138 minutes to 108 minutes.
在发生火灾的情况下，仓储电梯是有专人把它开到避难层，把避难层的人员 运送到楼下，实际上到后面。
In case of fire, and the designated working staff will take the shuttle elevators to each refugee floor in order to evacuate the people in the refugee floor down to the ground floor.
除此之外，在上海中心也设计了智能的消防应急和疏散指示系统。
And also the intelligent evacuation indicator system is also designed.
关于整个大厦的供水系统，这个呢是刘总刚才已经做了是详细的介绍，这里不多说了，主要是补充一点，我们这个大楼还设计了两根专门供消防队员使用的压缩空气泡沫滤管。
Madam Liu has already mentioned about the water supply system, but here I would like to particularly mention that we have also designed two special pipelines for the firefighters. So this is the two pipelines for the compressed air and foaming system.
这是消防泡沫滤管，专门是供消防部队灭火时候的用的，这样呢是提高灭火的有效性。
Yeah, because this compressed air foaming pipeline is dedicated to our firemen in order to improve the efficiency of firefighting.
超高层建筑消防安全是一个极为复杂的系统。
The fire safety system of the super tall building is a very complicated issue.
上海中心的消防安全设计可以说是达到了甚至在某些部分都超过了国家的标准，是可以能够提供一个高水准的消防安全环境的。
Yeah, for Shanghai Tower, we have already complied with or even exceed some of the national fire protection standards or codes, and thus we are confident that we can provide a very safe environment with sufficient fire protection.System.
谢谢大家，谢谢翻译。
Yeah, thank you for listening.